Hello and welcome to FlexSim 2017 Update 1. We're going to give you a quick tour of some of the features you'll find in the latest version of FlexSim's flagship simulation modeling software. We've greatly expanded our virtual reality capabilities in this release, adding compatibility for OpenVR and HTC Vive. And our existing Oculus compatibility has taken a major step forward with the Oculus Touch hand controllers. You can truly immerse yourself and interact with the FlexSim model in virtual reality. The natural gestures and finger movement of the Oculus Touch will let you push, pull, and lift your way to a more realistic simulation experience. Along with improvements to shadows in VR mode, you now have control over the shadow map resolution in FlexSim. You'll find this option in the Graphics tab of your Global Preferences, where you can choose a lower resolution that is ideal for computers that can't quite handle the default shadow resolution, or a higher resolution to make shadows look better on 4K monitors. We've also improved the 3D shape of the person flow item, so it's now consistent with the quality and realism of our current operator shape. The rack object adds some visualization enhancements of its own. These can be found in the new visual section of the rack's properties window, and they allow you to extend the columns beyond the top shelf, hide the floor on each shelf, and adjust the column spacing on the rack. FlexSim's web server application got a massive performance overhaul. It now uses Node.js, which streams the 3D view much faster. And it comes with a streamlined default GUI, making it better than ever before to run a FlexSim model over the web. Timetables now have the option for repeating events, making it easier to create schedules in your model. Repeating events can be created in date-based mode by using the checkbox and field at the bottom of the window, allowing you to have a piece of scheduling repeat at a specified interval, either for a number of occurrences or until a date and time. As for the process flow tool, you can now hold the control key and click and drag with the mouse to move activities within a block. And if you hold the alt key and click a token, it opens the token view, which is also available by right-clicking a token and selecting display token view. We've added new functionality in process flow and throughout FlexSim, so be sure to check out what's new in the user manual for more details. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoy FlexSim 2017 Update 1.